guys, Makeup and Young here with currently no makeup on. Today we're gonna have a little bit of a different video. I'm going to show you guys how I detangle my wigs because I currently have three. Well, actually technically I have four, but I have three longer wigs which I need to detangle. And yesterday I kind of got my brand new wish wig a little bit tangled because I went to SeaWorld and kind of had a blast. So she got a little bit of water on her. She's just not feeling so good. I have her right here on my lap and you can see she's a little, she's not too happy. She's not that bad, but she's not too happy. So I'm going to teach you guys how I detangle my wigs, what I use on them, what products I use, and kind of go through the steps of all that jazz. If you want to know more about the things I get on Wish, I am going to be doing a Wish haul very soon. I just have to get everything that I've ordered so far in, which is quite a bit of stuff, so hopefully you'll be sticking around for that. And let's just jump on into the video. Alright, hi guys. So I am going to be filming in a different part of my room. You guys usually see this in the background of me. Well, now I am here. Just to give you guys a better like perception of what's going on. It's harder to see over there. And so I have this little platform. And I have Deborah, who is going to be my head today, so that I can detangle this wig for you. So first of all, I have my wig, who I kind of want to name like Halsey, but at the same time, she doesn't look anything like Halsey. So I'm just going to take her, make sure all the hair is out of her, and then put her straight on to Deborah. Voila. And I'm going to turn her back, kind of get all the hair back into place where it should be. And then I'm going to take a few pins and just pin her down so that when I am combing her out, she doesn't move around on the head. Now, this is something that you're going to want to do with all wigs or even hair, and it's called strand testing. So she is definitely a very curly wig, and so before you comb her out, you want to make sure that combing her out won't hurt her curls, because there are certain ways to comb curly wigs out. So you're going to take a small strand of hair, and you're going to go from the very bottom and start brushing her out. And combing her does not seem to affect the curls that much, other than it does kind of volumize the hair. So I'm just going to go in. And this is the Healthy Sexy Hair Soy Tri Wheat Leave-In Conditioner. I know this is not a wig spray, but all of the wig detanglers that I have previously tried to use, they're not really good for wigs that are more soft than they are bulky. And so I like to use like literally the tiniest bit and just kind of stroke it through. And as you can see, that leaves it much curlier and much more defined. And this solution is really nice because I can wash it out of a wig. And on top of that, it's soy, which doesn't really have any crazy, I guess you would say, like filmy or crunchy chemicals, which is a big problem I had with a lot of other wig detanglers that I tried. They're very crunchy and chemical-y. So now I'm just going to keep taking strands, and I'm going to keep going from the bottom. You always want to brush a wig from the bottom up, and you don't want to take extremely huge strands as well, because that makes it harder if there are any little small tangles. I know it's really hard to get small tangles out of a wig, and so it's easier to try and divide those sections out. Now right here is a good example of maybe a bigger piece that is altogether a piece, but it has a little tangles within it. And so you're just gonna gently pull them apart and then take little small sections at a time and start brushing those out. I'm in a click, but I want out. It's not the same as when I was punched. In the old days, there was enough. The card games and ease with the bitter soul of blood. I was in, but I want out. My mother's love is choking me. I'm sick of words that hang above my head. What about the kid? It's time the kid got free. Once you get a section about this big of done hair, you're gonna go in with a detangler and just do like a 1-2 spritz, and that's really gonna give your curls on your wig some bounce again, and it's gonna kind of liven up the wig instead of being just one big frizzy mess. Kids, take the pill, make it too real. The other day I forgot my old address. I'm sitting pretty on the throne. There's nothing more I want except to be alone. Be a part of the love club. Everything will glow for you. Go get punched for the love club. For the love club. Something I like to do when I kind of have a big tangled section like this is I like to go from the bottom down, because usually the bottom is kind of the more tangled section. So just take the top, move it to the side, and you're going to take the smallest of pieces and just kind of work your way through that entire section piece by piece. So that way it's easier to comb out every little tangle instead of having to go at like 10 tangles at once. So I'm just going to take this small little section right here and start brushing her out. So what I like to do when I find a very small kind of knot in my hair, I don't know if you can see it very well, but I take my two fingers like this and I press the hair kind of right there, and then with my brush I go down, and it so it kind of hits my fingers, but it also gets that little section very well. And then I just kind of go back through a few times to make sure that the knot is completely out before I go and brush out the rest of that section. So one kind of method I like to use when I take the hair out of the clippy and it's kind of in this one little bundle, I'll go ahead and kind of toss it a little just to separate the hairs. And then you go find the next section you need to get and just kind of toss it while pulling it apart, because that kind of separates the hair a little bit more. And now you have... There you go. And now you have your entire section that you need to work with, and then you take small bits from this. So I'm going to take this big section, which is all your hair, clip that part back, and then you're just going to start from the bottom again. And as you can see, this is one huge tangle. And so you're just going to start kind of tossing it while lightly using your fingers to pull it apart until you have this. Now, this is a huge tangle, so you are going to use a bigger section for this just so that you're not damaging the hair when you pull it apart. And you're literally just going to start from the bottom and go all the way up. It will feel a little rough when you're trying to comb it out just because it is, you know, tangles are hard to pull out, but you're not usually damaging the wig. If anything, the wig will be a lot softer once you get the tangle out. Roll out your maps and papers, find out your hiding places again. Detangled, we're just going to go and run our fingers through her just a bit, just to kind of get those kind of bigger clumpy sections back in. All right, I'm going to scoop her hair up and place her back down. Now, for storage, I know a lot of people have actual wig storage containers or like holders in a place where they put their wigs. I don't. I have this plastic bag, but there is a certain way that you can kind of wrap your wig up so that it doesn't get tangled if you don't have a really secure place to put it. So I'm just going to take these little pins out of her. And let me give you full frontal view. I'm going to take her from right here and just slide her off. So you have her kind of like in the palm of your hands, and you're just gonna grab the very top, then grab kind of mid section in, and go half like that so that you're holding her almost like she has a ponytail. You're gonna kind of sleek it down, and then hold it from the tips, and then just kind of place her in to the very bottom of the bag, put the bag down, and wrap up the bag. So that way she can't move very much, and even if you kind of jiggle her, she can't get tangled.
You're back up close and personal. So some things I want to go over when you are detangling a wig are that there is going to be some light to moderate shedding, just like if you are really going over normal hair. There is going to be a little bit of fallout. That being said, it shouldn't be almost like the entire hair. If an entire chunk is coming out, then I would definitely recommend maybe trying to get a refund because that's not the best of wigs. I would also like to kind of give a big shout out to the app Wish. It's not a sponsored video, but I really like their synthetic hair and wigs and weave and all of that. They're so good. I haven't really seen anyone complain about the hair
that they've received. You do have to check the comments, though, because there are some that are kind of a little not so good. So it will say down in the comments below, oh, this one sheds a lot. Oh, this one kind of has a bald spot. You have to look out for those. But other than that, most of the people that receive the Wish wigs are amazed with how good they are. I think I got this for, I'm going to say, $12, and it's probably one of the best wigs I have, and I have a $50 wig in my closet right now, so it's unbeatable. You can't get a better deal than that, I think. So I think if you really want to start using weaves and wig products and synthetic hair products, you should definitely check out this app. If you want to see any more videos like this, please let me know. If you think this is just not even fun, that's okay. Let me know what else you want to see. Please like and subscribe, and also check out my Instagram channel, Makeup and Young, and have a nice day. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if there was no past. Doing it all.